Parental discretion is advised.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Wrestling Mayhem Show, episode 314.
What was that?
It's the intro to the show.
Welcome to the Wrestling Mayhem Show.
Yes. It's WrestleMania week.
WrestleMania.
Yes, and we are very, very excited for what's going on here.
Hey! You know who's excited for Cena Rock?
What?
This guy.
Oh, that guy. He's Chachi from InsertCoinToBegin.com.
This guy. I'm excited about Cena versus Rock. It's going to be the best match on the pay-per-view. Hands down.
Wow.
Saying it now.
Also with this is...
I say second best.
DJ Lunchbox.
Yes. Yes, DJ Lunchbox is with you. DJ Lunchbox, a.k.a. the Soulful Salad Maker, a.k.a. Pork Flank Steak, a.k.a. the best part of Batman's codpiece, a.k.a. Taco Man Salad, a.k.a.
Oh,
the
man.
Hot, the spicy, and oh-so-chewy DJ Saucebox. Here for your listening.
Go back to the taco one.
Taco Man
Salad?
Yes. Taco Man Salad.
Also join us from San Antonio, Texas, the Wrestle Fan.
Hi, Wrestle Fan.
AKA Taco Man Salad Jr.
Oh,
whoa.
That's right, folks. We're revealing it here on the Wrestle Man Show.
He's in the garage.
Wrestle Fan is my son.
WrestleMania weekend, I feel something.
And why do you just have a mustache now?
Because I'm a man. The man have mustache.
Love your beard, Wrestle Fan.
Love my beard.
I'm not laughing because it's ridiculous. I'm laughing because it's the best response. Because I'm a man, goddammit.
Rizz also joining us.
Thank you for having me. Just so you know, Wednesday we're going to have that mandatory Twitter meeting.
Okay.
You guys... All have to be there, and if you're not there, fire.
Fuck you, no.
And just a little footnote here: Chachi, Sorg, Wheelz, Lunchbox, Bobby, Wheelz. I said Wheelz twice.
Yes, you did.
All of you are okay.
Oh, I see what you did there.
You see what I did there?
I see what you did there.
You got me.
How am I in trouble?
You just got future endeavored.
Wow.
Yes, and also joining us, the man who can get a speeding ticket walking over to the studio, Wheelz. How you doing?
Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm excited because it's WrestleMania weekend coming up. But I had a better show this weekend with Chachi flying around a ring and not getting killed.
Hey, remind me to tell you my opinion on that one wrestler.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that opinion.
That's off air, though. This is, of course, the Wrestling Mayhem Show on the air. We're at Wrestling... That's the wrong thing. WrestlingMayhemShow.com is where you can find everything going on, including a lot of articles, WrestleFans Indie Report, Mad Mike's Impact Wrestling Report, as well as a bunch of other stuff. You can also tweet us at Mayhem Show, any comments about the show or anything like that. Hey, tag it, hashtag WMS314 if you have any comments about this episode. And, hey, drop us a line also on your emails at
Good times
at WrestlingMayhemShow.com or give us a call at what's that number, Chachi?
What's going on? Sorry. What do you have the phone number? 412-206-WMS0-9670 on your rotary dial phones.
And also go check us out.
Check out the app!
There you go, on your iPhone, iPad, or Android device. We are on the Amazon store as well. It's easier to find. I know we were getting tweets this week. I apologize. I don't know what's been going on with the Android store. Of course, they just changed it over to the Google Play store. So if anybody can find it, let us know. If you can't find it, let us know, and I'll start addressing this with our app provider, and we'll try to get it sorted out. But in the meantime, if you're on an Android device, I'm pretty sure if you're on an Android device, you can get to the Amazon store. Am I right, Chachi?
He's what? Right.
Are your headphones on? Yes. What did you just pull out of your ear? The Amazon store is easy to get to for an Android user, correct?
Yeah, download it from the app, Mark. Actually, no, you have to go to Amazon.com and look for it and download it, but it's easy to find.
But it's pretty easy. Yeah. It transfers over. So.
Super easy.
Because I know you can't get, like, for the most part, you can't get, like, from another store on the Apple device.
Right.
But it's a little different for you
right.
guys, of course.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Easy to get to.
Thank you.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
No, thank you.
No, thank you.
Back to you, Sorg.
All right, also any place to subscribe. It's iTunes, YouTube, Roku, stuff like that. We're all over the place.
All over. Facebook, Google Plus us.
Google
you can circle us.
MySpace.
That's a good place
to Tumblr.
Fuck MySpace.
People still use MySpace.
What
about Friendster?
What about Plurk?
Plurk?
Plurk.
We on Plurk? I don't think we're
no,
on
Plurk. Well, no. I'm not even on Plurk. I haven't touched it in a week.
Glad we didn't update on that. As usual, we like to start off with some email.
Fan mail?
Lots of yelling.
You can email us at...
Good that we already
good
did
time.
That part.
Good
Shut
time.
Up. We're doing it again.
Good time.
At WrestlingMayhemShow.com.
Wow.
Let's go to the inbox.
Right. We got an email.
With the jam cannon.
What?
You keep getting closer to your mic. I can't.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, we got an email here from Sonic Screwjob. Greetings, Mayhem Nation. Finally, the hype has come back to Atlanta. I will be the first to say that I have had about all the manufactured heat that the Rock Cena match can generate, but they have finally put together a promo worthy of WrestleMania. The Rock tried to fire up another Saturday Night Live skit early on, but when Cena came out, things started falling into place. Cena called Rock a visitor, claiming more time at the WWE and having business as usual on April 2nd to be... I think it's April 1st for Mania.
April 1st.
To be countered by The Rock's proclamation, he helped build Cena's office. And he just flat out didn't like Cena. Piqued my interest in this match over the pandering to the gimmick viewer that I had regulated it to in the past 6 weeks. Sorry about that. Past 12 months. I guess it all boils down to this. I'm John Cusack in One Crazy Summer. No. Don't give up on me yet. I can still save this analogy. I'm Hoops McCann, the average guy that everyone thinks is something that he's not, and pushes what they think he needs on him instead of what he actually wants. The Rock is Cookie Campbell, the hot blonde that everyone chases but can't have because her crazy overprotective boyfriend, Teddy, played by the Hollywood movie industry, who she'll never leave but teases everyone because Teddy isn't as good to hear as she wants.
Teddy Long?
No, I don't think so. She toys with Hoops, pretending she would leave Teddy, and all he offers for her, and Hoops wants her but knows it won't work, and while chasing Cookie completely forgets Cassandra, Cena, who has always been there and won't leave, until Hoops realizes he had what he always wanted, but didn't recognize it. Okay, maybe I didn't save it, but I tried. Have a great show, guys. Sonic Screw Job. And he also puts on here, P.S., is it just me, or is most of Team Teddy the job squad from 6 months ago? Booker has a pretty big job. Sorry, mission ahead of him. Sent from my iPod.
Sonic needs to stop drinking when he writes his emails. Or start.
Hey,
or drink more.
Or watching John Cusack movies. Yeah. So I know Chachi's excited about this match finally.
I am.
Talk about it.
I mean, I'm sorry, I didn't know you wanted me to go in.
And
can you turn me up? I feel like I'm low.
Well, you keep moving your mic. That's why.
I'm not going to yell, I promise.
Okay.
It started with the hour-long special at the beginning of Raw.
Okay.
I thought that was really good. I thought it was well done, and it was awesome to see.
Okay.
And then it got to the promo at the end, and the minute, and I didn't watch it until this morning, because I had to be at work extremely early, So I just fell asleep when Undertaker was coming up.
Wait, what?
Nothing. I said I fell asleep when Undertaker. I said I fell asleep when Undertaker was coming out.
Did you almost doze off now?
Yeah.
Okay.
And but
going around.
No, I went to sleep rather early, and so I rewatched it today. And I was sitting in my cube at work watching Raw, which is against company policy. And it got to the point where John Cena called Rock a visitor, and I stood up, I threw down the headphones, I was like, oh, snap, it's on! I got excited. That point that did it.
And you're on.
It's going to be the... It's going to be the match of the pay-per-view.
You know, I did not get a chance to watch the promo or the hour-long promo or anything like that. What did you guys think? That I know some of you guys watched it from the Hangout last night.
I thought it was a well-done documentary. Like, the filming of it was well done.
Aesthetically, it was pleasing.
Aesthetically, yeah. It was pleasing. I like the part where they go into, like, their childhood and stuff like that, and that part was pretty interesting.
The funniest part is what you said to me is, wait a minute, we see Cena's family talking about Cena, blah, 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 and all of a sudden they go to The Rock and they go to celebrities talking about his childhood.
Yeah, and they had Cena's mom and his five brothers and stuff like that talking about his childhood. And then they go to The Rock's childhood and it's like Vanessa Hudgens and
They had to do that because The Rock's family isn't as big.
Mm-hmm.
Like,
I know, but they still had his mother and that on there.
Well, yeah, but they couldn't fill the whole time with his mom and dad. So, I mean, they used what's around him.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they got impressions.
People that were never a part of his childhood.
Well, no, they weren't.
No, I think they were, though.
They weren't looking.
Vanessa Hudgens was?
No, it was co-stars from Journey.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Oh, never mind.
And they weren't looking for information about his childhood from that. They wanted to know what they thought of the picture of that child. And that was how they filled his part of the time, because he didn't have five brothers to sit there and each say, like, 2 minutes worth of stuff.
Well, yeah. I mean, I just felt like kind of, like, awkward in that sense. And, like, I mean, my thoughts on it was, you know, it was a good documentary. It's just didn't really change any of my thoughts of the two. Does that make sense?
Okay.
Like, it didn't change my opinion on the match. Later on Raw, maybe, yes. But that documentary...
Well, no. I mean... It didn't change my opinion on the match either. It was just super informative, and it was really cool to see. Like, I didn't know that John Cena wears a Make-A-Wish shirt that's signed by Make-A-Wish Kids.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I respect the guy already because, I mean, he does so much, but that just upped the amount of respect that I have for him.
Yeah. I could have done without the part they did on the Twitter war.
Why? That's a crucial
part. That's a part of the thing.
It's a crucial part to the thing. I just felt like that. I hated the whole Twitter involvement in this whole storyline in general. So that part just kind of turned me off. So.
Well,
but other than that, I liked it.
And also, it was informative because I had no idea that Rock had been named. Chief in Samoa yet?
Sorry. Oh, yeah, I didn't hear. Samoa? Yeah, I never knew about that. Yeah.
I didn't know about that.
It's very cultural. I mean,
well, yeah, I know, is. But I figured I didn't know it happened already, okay. Is what I'm saying. Like, I knew it would happen, because, I mean, his grandfather was a king chief, and his dad was a king chief.
Yeah, high chief. Yeah,
chief Maivia.
Oh, his dad was?
Yeah.
Like, Rocky Johnson was a chief, and he's not even Samoan. That's interesting.
Yeah.
So, wow, I mean, that's impressive.
So... I mean, yeah, I didn't know that happened already. I thought that was cool to know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, and the fact that even they even complimented each other in this documentary.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and other superstars complimenting them. Like, I think it was JR, maybe, said that Cena could be going 900 directions and then be told that there's a kid waiting to see him and drop everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I don't know how many people have seen that. What was it? The John Cena Experience.
Right.
Sorry about that. But I mean, yeah, you'd see like WrestleMania weekend, and they had like 30,000 pictures lined up, just like a long ass table, and him going there and signing.
Yeah, they talked about that. That's what he does in his downtime.
Yeah, basically, and all those guys when they get to that level, and of course, you know, him more than anybody, it seems. But yeah, that's him. If you don't watch that John Cena DVD and be impressed with the guy, you know, I mean, just for, you know, everything he does, he can't fake a lot of that stuff.
Right. You know? No, I have tons of respect for John Cena, especially. Go ahead, Chachi.
No, go ahead.
Well, I mean, just, you know, there are a lot of, you know, the Cena people that, you know, complain about, you know, the stuff we see on TV and stuff like that. But, you know, I have much respect. Honestly, I'm that kind of wrestling fan that really respects, like, 99% of the wrestlers. Just from the fact that, you know, they do something that, you know, is to entertain us. But the fact that John Cena goes out and does all this amazing stuff, you know, you really do have to respect him for that. As much people want to say, you know, wears the Cena sucks t-shirts and get on that trend, then I mean, you know, he's a stand-up guy, he's a company guy, and I think that's, you know, sort of like what's most important about him.
From the chat room, I wanted to mention, Bobby says he liked the story of Cena's brother and The Rock. So I mean,
I mean, my favorite part of the entire thing last night was right after they started talking about Cena's Make-A-Wish stuff. They showed him receiving an award from Make-A-Wish because he's a celebrity that's filled more wishes than anyone else for that organization.
Uh-huh.
And then it immediately cut to the bus, and him saying, that was an awesome honor, but that's not why I do it. And the fact that there were cameras there doesn't change a thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, that was the best part because, I mean, that was him being real and saying that that wasn't why he filled all these wishes and that he would have done it anyhow. So,
yeah.
Yeah. You don't see that many guys do kind of stuff like that in this industry or any industry. I mean, you see a lot of celebrities, some that are just snub a fan or try to run away and not be seen in public. But
yeah.
You got John Cena, and I mean, probably a few other WWE stars who make that time. It's like, all right, I may have to go out to do this in 5 minutes, but that fan's been waiting for a while. I'm going to go see them first.
Right. Yeah. Like, and not to say anything bad about them, like when they were in that era, I don't even think like a Hogan or like an Austin or a Rock would have done that in that era. Yeah. Cena's one of the guys that really does, and he's mentioned in his promos against The Rock, you know, many times he fights for his fans. If there's people out there they want to boo him, that's fine, but he fights for his fans. You know, they're the ones that brought him to the dance. That's, you know, what's most important.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Interesting points brought up from while we're talking Rock Cena, that he, you know, we talked about, you know, is really. We were into the when he called him a visitor, like Chachi said.
Yeah.
But the thought that, like, Cena's been around longer than The Rock was around.
Right.
At this point.
Well, I mean,
That's a good point.
No, I mean, John Cena was not lying when he called The Rock a visitor.
Mm-hmm.
Because, yes, John Cena has been along longer than The Rock was around previously. And at this point, as much as I love him and have always loved The Rock, that's all he is.
Mm-hmm.
He's a house guest that just shows up from time to time.
Mm-hmm. Right.
This isn't his business anymore. And while it was true that he said that he built the house that Cena, or the office that Cena goes to every day now, I mean, it's still, Cena's still right.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Cena, and especially, like, I know you guys were a fan. You guys were fans around the, you know, the Attitude Era and stuff like that. You were around for that period of time. When I was getting into wrestling, it was right around the time when Rock went to Hollywood.
Yeah.
Right.
So I didn't even get sort of that experience. So even more with The Rock coming in, you know, just to do like, oh, to go in for a Diva Search contest. And they're going to make fun of, you know, Jonathan Coachman. And now he's coming in and saying, oh, now I want to be here. Even for myself, I'm like, well, no, you're not, you know. You're here to promote a movie, or you're here to, you know.
Yeah, so you have a different perception of it.
Listen, anytime Rock wants to step in the ring, I'm going to get excited.
Mm-hmm.
if he picks up the microphone, I'm going to get goosebumps. It's just because I know The Rock. I love The Rock.
You're a big fan.
I am a huge fan of The Rock.
I think most of and our friends, I mean, back in the day, most of our friends, I think, were more Stone Cold fans, and you were The Rock guy.
And that's, believe it or not, I can connect it to why I like Cena.
Mm-hmm.
It was the same thing.
It was.
Different time periods, same thing. Both would come out, both would say amazing things on the microphone, both would throw awesome matches, and then leave. Rock left, Cena came in, he did amazing things on the microphone that entertained the hell out of me and everyone else. And despite what anyone else wants to say, had awesome matches and continues to do so.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, people can boo him all he wants. This guy is still going to like him.
Exactly. Yeah. Excellent. Rizz, you got any, you've been a little quiet over there.
I know. I've been quiet. I don't know why.
But he's indifferent.
When I first saw I caught it at the tail end of it.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't get to see the whole backstory about it and all that stuff. But what I took from that, it was a good informative piece about that whole for that hour. Mm-hmm. But
who has a modem?
What was that?
No, that was Wheelz. Oh, okay. Yeah, it's his CV.
But the thing that was cool was The Rock did something I thought he'd never do.
Mm-hmm.
He adapted. He adapted to the style that we all see now with Cena, Jericho, and Punk. He's starting to adapt the way he speaks. He doesn't do the one-liners in front of the face of Cena anymore. He just says, okay, I'm going to kick your ass. And that was it. It's like, all he wanted.
Sorry.
Go ahead, go.
To add to what Rizz is saying, you're right, he's not doing one-liners anymore, because the whole thing nowadays is setting up for the punchline.
Mm-hmm.
Like, these are whole series of things.
Mm-hmm.
And if I could throw in another point, besides the times when they were supposed to, i.e. A year ago at the Raw before WrestleMania and at WrestleMania 27 and at SummerSlam, are the only times they've physically touched each other.
Mm-hmm.
They've done this entire year-long back and forth without kicking each other's ass.
So would you say this is a challenge? Because we always say about how everything's hot-shotted month by month and everything. So was this the big experiment to say, let's bring back that long build from back in the day, let's do something old school, but with the new school? I remember how long it was before Sting touched Hogan. I mean, that was the last time I can remember anything that lasted nearly this long.
Yeah, up until, I mean, recently it's been contract stipulation.
Yeah.
You can't touch him or you lose this, blah, blah. But, I mean, they did this entire year-long feud without physically laying a finger on each other.
How do you think this year-long feud is going to be remembered after this? Because, I guess it depends on Sunday, doesn't it?
Depends.
It really does.
It depends on the match.
Because
they didn't lay a finger on each other. Rock bottom Cena at Survivor Series.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, but okay. I think with this year-long feud, there have been a lot of success. There's a lot of success that came from it, but there are also a lot of issues.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, you know, they can take those issues and learn from them and hopefully do another thing like this again, where you have a feud that builds for you, not even a year, but I mean, like, say, like 6 months or 8 months or something like that. And just, you know, I think there were a lot of success and a lot of pitfalls, but that can definitely be a learning process in WWE doing something like this again.
It all depends on Sunday.
Yeah. If it turns out to be like a Hogan Andre, then yes, it's perfect. But then if it ends up being
Goldberg Lesnar.
Exactly. I was going to say that.
Goldberg. If it ends up Goldberg Lesnar,
they're going to lose a
lot
of money.
We're screwed.
WWE is done. Well, not done, but I mean, they'll never try anything like this again.
Yeah. Right.
But if it turns out being Hogan Andre, then chances are we'll see this again.
Not even Hogan Andre, but like Rock Hogan.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I definitely think there was a lot of good from this. The only thing is I wish, you know, last night's ending of Raw was so good. It's just I wish they would have done that for the past like 4 weeks. Instead, they gave us, like, sort of shit this past couple weeks, and now we get something really good.
You gotta stretch it out. You gotta stretch it out, though, you know? They that's being patient. They didn't, you know, drop the ball. They didn't, you know, blow their load early on this one. They paced it very, very intelligently, if you look at it.
And honestly, they didn't drop the ball the past couple weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And we pointed this out before. What they did was they tried to take Rock's style of the 90s and use it in this new era.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't work in this new era.
And they've had to do a lot of moving. Right. You know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, and now I think they finally got the writing down and they got the promo styles down and they got to the point where it got me excited for the match on Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
When before, I was more looking forward to Sheamus and Daniel Bryan's or
Punk and Jericho.
Yeah, or Punk or Jericho. And now, I'm more excited for a non-title match at WrestleMania than I am the title matches.
Exactly. LP, what do you think of all this going on?
I'm a little bummed because I went to bed early last night and missed Raw, and everyone is really excited about this match now and very warm over.
Oh, just go last if you go to Daily Motion, you just watch the last two parts of Raw by, it's like a Tele TV or something like that.
Yeah, they're usually really easy to find it. So.
Yeah.
I mean,
I had an interesting conversation with Jack Bunja, who's done, you know, a handful of things on the show before, and we were talking about how the card is going to lay out. Is my video frozen?
Yeah, you're frozen. Yeah. You're very concentrating.
Yes.
It's all right. Go ahead.
So Rock and Cena is clearly the big main event for WrestleMania. It's the money draw, but classically, they put the title on last at WrestleMania, so is it going to be Rock and Cena in the main event?
You know what it's going to be? It's going to be Lawrence Taylor, Big Bam Bigelow.
Big Bam Bigelow?
Big Bam Bigelow. Huh?
There you go.
I could see that.
Well, no, that's what it is. This is the feature match regardless. I mean, this isn't the first time the title has not been on the line in WrestleMania. Hell, it was a tag match in the first WrestleMania. We had that feature match at WrestleMania, was it 11? I'm sure, you know, most of them end with a title match, but not all of them. Hell, wait, which one did last year? No, last year they ended with that
last
one.
Last year was title.
The Taker match.
Yeah, Taker Michaels wasn't title.
Taker Michaels ended the second time, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah, there you go.
Remember the second one? I knew the first one was, like, right smack in the middle of the card.
It was.
I'm kind of hoping, honestly, that they let this one be the final match and not Taker, Triple H, Michaels, because I think Rock and Cena could pull it off a little bit better.
Yeah. Well, this one had an hour special. They've been promoting for a year. This is the main event. I don't think there's absolutely any question that this is the main event of the show and will go on last like it as
there's,
it should.
There is no way.
I mean, there are some great matches building up to this, but there is nothing near what we are seeing with Cena, Rock, and the expectations here. Go ahead, Wrestle Fan.
I was going to say, maybe you could have said that, you know, a couple weeks ago. Especially after last night, there's no way Triple H Taker is going main event.
No way.
What did they do last night for Triple H Taker?
No, they didn't.
They did a promo.
They had their last thing. They had their face-to-face last week. That was your build-up. They had the face-to-face for the other guys this week, and there you go.
I will say the one match that, and people can say what they want about this, the one match that the build-up has dropped the ball is Taker Triple H.
I don't know. I don't think it really needed much
for it.
It needs much for it. It's just like, we're doing this, and this is the reason. And that's all you need. You know, I think it speaks for itself.
I don't know. And maybe we'll get into this later during the roundtable. But it's just, I don't know. I don't feel – I definitely with Rock and Cena, I'm very excited now about that match, and I'm excited about some of the other matches on the card, but WrestleMania just doesn't feel as important this year.
All right. We'll talk a little bit more about that. Before that, I know we had a little bit of a roundtable here, but we got some big stuff coming up. Of course, we're going to be unveiling the Mayhemmies. Man, Mike, and myself, of course. Let's hit with the Wrestle Fan. Tell us what's going on in the world of indie.
Well, this week in indie wrestling, we're going to talk first about something we mentioned last week on the show from our good friend Zach Rain from the now defunct AON Wrestling. More information has come out about the new Johnstown independent pro wrestling company that is going to be emerging. I believe it's called Phoenix Pro Wrestling. They have the sort of a flyer here, and they also have some promos up. Apparently, April 20th, 2012 will be the introduction of this company. A lot of the area's top stars. It'll be at the Masonic Temple in Johnstown, PA. Doors open 6 p.m., bell time 6:45. So it's going to be interesting definitely to see.
Have you seen this video?
I'm sorry?
Have you seen the video for this?
Yeah, there's ninjas involved.
Hold on, I'm trying to bring it up. I'm trying to find it on the page.
And not those ninjas, the other ninjas.
I'm glad you said that. I was thinking the same thing. I'm like, no, you can't specify that the way we talk on this show.
We talked about the Urban Wrestling Federation last week.
So there is a little bit. Who is this? This is
Marcus the Nomad Cage, I believe.
Yeah. This involves a lot of here's his wallet. And he fights ninjas, and it's about 4 minutes, and I got to say it's worth your time. And if this is the kind of thing going into this for a wrestling fed, considering the people involved and the stuff we've heard on the show about the former fed that ran in Johnstown, and I imagine there's a lot of people involved from that. I'll take a wrestling fed where there's a ninja wearing jeans and getting his ass kicked in the middle of a field. By the way, very dreary in Johnstown, according to this video. And MMA is the way. I unfortunately, that's the weekend. We're going to Pittsburgh Comic Con again, Wrestling Mayhem Show, Sorgatron Media, so we will not be able to attend that. But I really, really excited to see wrestling's continue going in Johnstown, especially all the stuff we hear about out there formerly. So, go ahead.
Very cool. Up next here on the Indie Minute, I'm going to talk a little bit about Chikara Pro Wrestling, a company we haven't talked about in a little while. But this past weekend, they had their event in Canada, their debut in Canada, which I was told went off very well. They crowned new Campeones de Parejas when 3.0 of Shay Matthews and Scott Parker defeated the team of Fists of Chuck Taylor and friend of the show Johnny Gargano. It was a big win for them, definitely, especially in their home country of Canada. So congratulations to them. There's more Chikara events coming up, including Chikara's involvement at the upcoming Ring of Honor events. That will be WrestleMania weekend. At WrestleMania weekend, they're having Showdown in the Sun nights 1 and 2, which night 1 will feature a triple threat match for the ROH World Title between Davey Richards, Roderick Strong, and Eddie Edwards. And basically, the champion of that match will face whoever they're facing the second night will be a title match. So I believe it's Jay Lethal taking on Roderick Strong in the second night. Eddie Edwards is taking on Kevin Steen, and Davey Richards—I forgot who Richards is facing. It slipped my mind, but whoever wins the first night will go on to the second night, and that match will be a title match. Also, Lance Storm will be making his Ring of Honor return to face the Prodigy Mike Bennett, who will be accompanied by Maria Kanellis of WWE fame. And also, speaking of the relation with Chikara wrestler is actually going to get a match that weekend on WrestleMania weekend, when TJ Perkins goes one-on-one with Fire Ant of the Colony. So that's definitely going to be a very interesting thing to see how this whole Ring of Honor Chikara thing is going to develop. And so you can order the iPay-per-views. Go to ROHWrestling.com and get more information on that and check them out. Also about iPay-per-views and about WrestleMania weekend, Dragongate USA is holding a iPay-per-view. WrestleMania weekend, I don't remember if it's Saturday or Friday or Saturday.
I think it's Saturday.
I think so too, but you can actually get the iPay-per-view. It's only live. You can buy it with live and on demand, but you can buy it exclusively live for only $1.99.
It is Friday. I'm sorry.
Friday.
Yeah, it looks like.
Yeah, so that opened the Ultimate Gate with the main event of Pac taking on Loki, nice. Which is definitely going to be a great match. Yes, you can order the exclusively the live iPay-per-view for only $1.99. If you want to get the iPay-per-view and have it on demand, it'll be the regular $14.99. But that's definitely a great, you know, and deal.
I want to point out here, it looks like there's three main events according to this. Okay. There's the one you mentioned, Loki and Pac. Chima and Ion. Chima and Ricochet against Chuck Taylor and Rich Swann for the Open United Gate title.
Which is basically their tag team title.
Okay. And Masaka Mochizuki versus Akira Tozawa. Yeah. But no, there's a bunch of great stuff here. Sabu's on here. Pinky Sanchez. Sammy Callahan's always great. I hear good things about, is that B-by-B Hulk? Is it how you say
BB Hulk.
BB Hulk, okay. I mean, it looks like a really stacked show, and they're always good bringing these Japanese talents in. They're just tremendous on these things. But yeah, go check that out. If you wanted to check out an iPay-per-view, that's the way to do it.
That sounds like a really great one.
DGUSA.TV. I'm really excited. Oh, it's on Friday. I'm traveling that night. damn it. This can't win. Man, well, you know what? If they're doing that, you could order it and I could catch a replay a little bit later. I think I'm doing that for $1.99. Why not? You know, why not? Why not? Even if I check in a little later, right? So go check that out. Oh, yeah. Anything else there, Wrestle Fan?
Also, in the Indie Man this week, I'm going to talk about friends of the show, Anarchy Championship Wrestling over in Texas. They have a bunch of new matches announced for their April event entitled Peace, Love, and Anarchy. Including Jerry Lynn will be there to announce the next opponent, basically in his final year of professional wrestling. Okay. And you know, working a lot with ACW, he'll be able to have a lot of great matches to come. Also, the ACW heavyweight title will be on the line as ACH defends in a four-way against the infamous Sean Vex, Gary J of the Submission Squad, and Biohazard Jake Iskutskin, which that's going to be a really great match. A lot of great stuff there. If you want to get your tickets, go to anarchychampionshipwrestling.com. Reserve front row 15, general admission $10. It's at the Mohawk in Austin, Texas. I'll be there. It's definitely going to be a great event. Also, for our fans at Anarchy Championship Wrestling, you can head over there to anarchychampionshipwrestling.com, and under their blog section, you can check out some photos of some of the ACW American Joshis in yoga pants.
Yeah, I was showing those off a little bit there.
That's a little treat for everyone out there. So,
who doesn't love Blazions in
yoga pants?
It's definitely very interesting. And I believe there's actually a match that should be coming out soon on their YouTube channel of, the Joshis in yoga pants. So,
nice.
That'll definitely be a really good show. And also, now I'm going to pass it over to, I believe, Wheelz, who's going to talk about the new stuff coming out for RWA.
What?
Wow.
Or somebody to talk about.
Did you know you had a spot? What's the new stuff? Is there new stuff?
They have new stuff?
Do we have new
Damn.
Stuff?
Fire whistles.
Oh,
sorry,
no.
Folks. Hey, guess what?
What?
A Sorgatron.
Huh.
Did you know that RWA now has a after show?
What? What after show are you speaking of?
I'm speaking of RWA wrap-up. Thank you, Sorgatron Media.
Yes, the concept that was dropped in the middle of nowhere, and there you have it. So if you're curious what's going on there, there's some nice, you know, we got the concept like really kind of short-termed, but as you can see there in the video, the wrestlers are still out signing autographs and stuff. There's some clips in there and everything. And
his hair is really flippy.
I think having a show up the next day that is literally from minutes after a show ends may be very beneficial. So
honestly, I think you did a good job. I think Chachi did a great job. Honestly, the wrestlers and talent, that crowd was hot this weekend.
It was.
I mean,
it was nuts.
Your opinion, Chachi, your Sorg. I mean, I'd love to hear it. Well, Chachi, leave that one part out until after the show.
Yeah.
I know.
You commented on how loud it was.
All right, so the way this works is I run my cable,
mm-hmm.
And then minutes before the show starts, I go plug in. And while plugging in, I have a headset that's connected to Sorg.
Yeah.
Sorg lets me know if there's somewhere he wants me to go, if there's a shot he wants me to get.
Mm-hmm.
He lets us know, because there's actually two of us on camera, he lets us know which camera it's on. That way, the other one can adjust, if need be.
Yeah.
That way, I'm not moving. And that is a gorgeous shot, by the way. But it lets us know not to move because he's using what we're showing.
Yeah.
Well, I couldn't hear him.
Yeah, there's a few flubs in there because of that situation.
I could not hear him.
It was a little bit
the crowd, I don't know if it was all of the crowd or just that side that I was standing on most of the night. Mm-hmm. I could not hear him.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you're talking, and I don't know if this is a factual piece of information or not, but they're saying it was the largest crowd.
One of the largest
at an RWA show, which is about 300 to 400 people.
No, it was the numbers were like around 250.
Was it?
Yeah.
Because everyone kept saying 300.
All I heard on commentary was 250.
Okay, so I could not hear. So,
I mean, I agree with you, Chachi. I mean, I could see what you're talking about because I'm over by the sound, and you figure I'm by those speakers.
Yeah.
And that crowd almost
overpowered
the speakers.
Side note, just because I see it on the video, I'm getting one of those things for our microphone for Sorgatron Media. So
you're not professional unless you have a little microphone. Yeah,
they showed up then. I'm like, that looks good.
If you want my honest opinion on the show, most of it was awesome.
Yeah.
There are some points that I just I think needed a little more work.
Always. Right. I mean, you're not going to have a great show every time. And RWA,
exactly.
RWA is one now. I've been very honest about, they've been getting the pacing down and everything. It hasn't felt like, because I remember I used to go to RWA shows and it just felt like, oh my God, is this match over yet?
Yeah, exactly.
You don't get that as much anymore. But I thought the order of the matches was a little weird.
Yeah, the order of the matches was weird. They had all of the important matches after the intermission.
Yeah. Like, that threw me a little bit.
There was no build up to some of the other matches. Like Sorg and I were talking on the way back, and we said we would have put the tag champion match
something
right before intermission.
Because Kato, but that didn't feel like the match to go to. I don't know. But that's a booking thing. But still, all together, I thought it was still a fun show.
And honestly, most of it was pulled off well. I just didn't dig the ladder match.
Mm-hmm.
That match specifically, it needed more work, honestly.
Yeah.
But, I mean, overall, I enjoy all the shows that I'm there for. There hasn't been the dog is itching.
I think the dog's itching so very loudly upstairs.
But,
Wow.
But honestly, I have to say, I agree with you, Chachi. I mean, but honestly, I swear, since like January, this was, I think, one of the hottest and one of my most favorite shows to date so far.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I honestly, I hope everything that's going on that's new, like I said, with the wrap up, the website's getting updated and a new face to it. So honestly, I hope everything starts going even more upswing and stuff like that for the RWA. And I'm proud to say I'm part of that family, and it's good to have Sorgatron Media along.
Thank you. Honestly, I think my favorite show for RWA so far this year would be the January one if the awards ceremony stuff wouldn't have been there.
Right.
I think that pretty much killed it for me. But, I mean, as far as the matches and everything go, I think that was my favorite one.
Yeah.
Excellent. Hey, you know, just because I got the Facebook message. Hey, is there anything else there, Wrestle Fan?
That's all I have this weekend.
Hey, Wrestle Fan. That was a great indie minute.
Yeah,
Yes. Don't listen yes, to I totally talk. Agree, Russell. Yes.
Don't listen to Russell. Thank you, Chachi. I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Good work. Good work.
Wait. We have one more thing we need to do for the Indie Minute. I apologize, Chachi. Oh. Wheelz, we talked about your excitement last week. I want you to put over the new wrap-up show and the new DVD.
Ah, yes, yes.
I thought you just...
No. I want him to put it over.
Oh, gotcha.
Are you ready?
Ready.
Bring it on in 3, 2, 1.
Ladies and gentlemen, wow, I am totally excited. We got a wrap-up show, and we got a teaser for this past weekend's show. And I mean, wow, if you weren't there, I totally wish you would pick up and go to Sorgatron Media and pick up March 34. Why? I'll tell you why. Ladders. And big black men.
No, it's not that guy with DVD. Oh man, I am pretty sure Wheelz does not have an angry bone in his body. I think that's what it is. Thanks, Wheelz. Oh, hey, go check that out. Hey, we're gonna check. Thanks, Wrestle Fan, again for the Indie Minute.
Are you gonna show the preview?
What?
Are you gonna show the preview?
I'm getting to that. Okay. We're gonna go check in, see what's going on. Go get that app on the Amazon Store and iOS iTunes Store as well, and we'll see about that Google Play Store. And after that, we are going to have that teaser for the DVD we just talked about. So, and we'll be back talking about Mayhemmies, WrestleMania, Mad Minutes, and remember. Number one?
Come on, host of the year. Come on, host of the year.
Shit, ninja, shit,
man.
What the fuck are we doing?
Starting ninja, show.
Please. Who am I?
Oh, I thought we were on the show.
Oh, yeah. No, we're not.
All right.
Sorry, I was watching Source Fed.
All right, we are back. Thanks, Mad Mike, for the minute of mayhem. You had something there, Chach?
I do.
You were thinking about the
back.
Hey guys,
Wrestle Fan as Phil Cosby coming back.
I'm telling you, I make tracks so hard in this known as cement break. Simply by sampling it in and made on a cassette tape. Cause my words are so vivid, I'm
living. Oh my god!
I rhyme, but I can't even spell the words. Like if you wanna smoke a blunt, but you can't roll the earth. Fuck spoken word, I'm choking dope until my throat is hurt. I'm holding a dopamine changing with the open world. Scoping over these things with my fangs to the girl. I said crank it up, turn this shit and bang it up. I said crank it up, burn a bitch and slang a star. I said crank it up, twist the wrist and flame it up. I said crank it up, motherfucker, crank it up.
Hey, Wrestling Mayhem Show fans, we're back, and it is time for a little segment that we like to call Remember When.
We look to the side because we remember the wrestling.
Do I go from that sort or you want to do another thing?
Just go.
Okay, we're going. So WrestleMania is around the corner, ladies and gentlemen. It's the granddaddy of them all. It's the biggest show of the year for the WWE, which is the biggest company in wrestling, which means it's even bigger. So basically, my first WrestleMania that I ever saw was WrestleMania 19. As you know, I got into wrestling sort of, you know, at a, you know, not the same time as everyone else on the show. The first WrestleMania I ever saw was WrestleMania 19, which was in Seattle, Washington at Safeco Field. For me, you know, never seeing an event like that before, it was a really interesting thing to see a jam-packed, you know, field just, you know, jammed with people to see wrestling, something I'd never seen before. That show was packed with main events, Brock Lesnar versus Kurt Angle, Hulk Hogan and Vince McMahon going at it over their big, you know, Who Started Hulkamania thing. Chris Jericho and Shawn Michaels would put on a classic match that would start a great series of matches between the two. But one of the big ones, and one that can sort of be related to what is happening this year at WrestleMania, was the big matchup between The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin. Now, this match, I sort of, you know, obviously I wasn't big into wrestling for a long time. I sort of didn't get to see The Rock in his high period, like I mentioned before. I saw him right when he was leaving to go to Hollywood, and then... And then he sort of trickled back into the fold here with Steve Austin, who was still very big at that time, still very, you know, much a part of, you know, of the company, and not knowing, and obviously not knowing the backstory of what was going to happen after that match, but, you know, it was a point where, you know, two men from one era finally deciding, you know, who was going to be the best and who was going to come out on top. And for me, not even being a part of that era as a wrestling fan, it still meant a lot to me, because you saw how much it meant to others. The build up to this match was really great. A lot of great back and forth stuff between Rock and Steve. You know, it was their third matchup at WrestleMania, so it was really going to be the deciding factor. It was going to be something really big, and obviously, from what we know now, that was the last match that Steve Austin has wrestled. He hasn't wrestled a single match since then. Obviously, he's made appearances in WWE and that, and he's one of those few wrestlers that hasn't really. I watched WrestleMania 19 documentary. It was actually a really well produced thing, and Austin mentioned that, you know, because of my neck and because of everything that's been going on, tonight's my last match. I'm fine with it being my last match. You know, I'm going out, and that's something that can be really commendable, because you don't really see that a lot. You don't see that a lot with sort of the older generation deciding, hey, there's a time I need to hang it up, and there's a time that I'm, you know, going to leave with that legacy I have intact. And that was sort of, I think with Rock and Cena, obviously it may not be that way with The Rock. I really don't think this would keep him from ever returning to wrestling and being in a match again, but it definitely feels like it's a culmination of something. It's a culmination of a dream match that a lot of wrestling fans have, you know, if you think of dream WrestleMania matches, John Cena and The Rock is up there, just like Rock Hogan was. So there's a lot of going into this match that people may not see on TV, people may not see in the promos, people see the promos are very, you know, stale and boring and stuff like that, but it's more than that. To a degree, The Rock and Cena could go out and not say anything. And they could just, you know, they could have had no build up to this match, and it's definitely still going to be an attraction. You know, it's that thing that, you know, a lot of people can't have in a wrestling match. That's why I'm excited for WrestleMania. That's what I remember with Hulk, with The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin, and that is this week's Remember When.
Thank you, Wrestle Fan, and with that, we're going to Mad Mike's Minute of Mayhem, and after that, we get to find out the Mayhemmies and more WrestleMania talk leading into the big weekend. Right back. Ready for the fucking race. Hello, nice.
Get deep out of the force. Starting the fight. Howdy, Mayhemmers. It's Mad Mike once again with your Minute of Mayhem. Now, WrestleMania is this weekend, and it's going to be an interesting show. I don't know if I'm necessarily excited. I'm excited for two matches on Mania. Punk and Jericho, just because it's going to be a great match. Not really storyline or anything, but it's just going to be a really fun match to watch. And, of course, Rock Cena. I think it's going to surprise a lot of people how well The Rock performs. At least I hope so. Because coming from someone who was at Survivor Series and saw The Rock not really sell anything, not really taking any moves, taking any bumps, I think he took two, maybe three bumps in that whole match, and I think we're going to see something special in Mania, at least I hope we are, because the special that they had before Raw this week was pretty decent, although again, it's WWE, if they want people to cheer John Cena, people need to watch that special, because Brock, like, he doesn't come off as an asshole. He just comes off as you know, a guest host. He comes off as the celebrity. And hell, here we all thought Maria Menounos was going to be the celebrity this year. But Maria, I don't know. It's going to be an interesting dichotomy. And I think people are going to boo the fuck out of Cena when he wins. Because, I mean, let's face it, Cena is winning. That's how this is going down. I think Sheamus has to win, because the past couple of years we've had Royal Rumble winners that haven't won. And I think if Sheamus doesn't win this year, then the percentage of Royal Rumble winners drops like below 50%. So that'd be pretty bad. Taker, obviously gonna win. And I think it's gonna be a great match. But I really hope it's clean. I hope there's no ref bumps, even though there will be because it's Shawn Michaels. I hope there's no super kicks. As much as I love Shawn Michaels, I really don't want to see a super kick at all. When Taker, I heard this on our podcast, it'd be funny if when Taker gets pinned, Shawn's like, I'm sorry, I love you, three. You know, when Triple H's shoulders are on the mat, that would be pretty interesting. But yeah, Team Teddy and Team Johnny, not really that important. I mean, they say it is, but I don't think it is. No one really told me when Johnny became the permanent GM of Raw. So I don't know how technically you can lose that job if you're not a permanent GM while gaining another job. That's just me. But anyway, have a good Mania weekend, guys. Hall of Fame should be fun. JBL inducting Farouk should be awesome. And Christian inducting Edge should be magical. Well, that's it for me, guys. Take care. It doesn't spike. Spike your hair. Ooh, you know, bitches.
All right, we are back. Thanks, Mad Mike, for the minute of mayhem. You had something there, Chach?
I do. Who are the tag belts being defended against?
At WrestleMania?
Yeah.
They're not.
Who is the United States Championship being defended against?
He's in a, I don't know, but he's in a 6-man or a 12-man tag match.
Exactly.
That happens.
Dude, not at WrestleMania!
Yes, it does.
Yes, it does.
What's the last time?
WrestleMania!
How many years were we like, no belts being defended?
Hey.
The Intercontinental belt's being defended.
Who's the women's title being defended against?
No.
Exactly! Exactly! What's supposed to be three major titles aren't being defended!
Chachi, you're saying, the women's title is not being defended, the tag title is not being defended, the U.S. title is not being defended at WrestleMania. What else is new?
I'm hard-pressed to tell you who has the U.S. title, and I don't give a fuck. Look at the huge... the card is stacked without these titles. So
yeah, that's true.
No, stop. Stop. Time out. The card is not stacked. The card has The card has four possible good matches. One of which is going to bomb horribly. And the other
three
matches are going to be good.
Chachi can't count.
I mean, all right, let's list bullshit match number one. The tag women's match. I'm going to take a shit. Let's list bullshit match number two. This 12-man tag match to determine who's the general manager of a fucking show that no one's watching.
Everybody's got to get their paycheck.
That has one of the fucking champions in the match that should be defending.
That's two, actually.
Hey, you know what another match I don't give a shit about?
Mm.
Randy Orton versus Kane. Go fuck yourself. You're telling me that these two are going to fight at WrestleMania because Kane showed good sportsmanship and shook someone's fucking hand? Fuck you, WWE!
I don't think Josh is coming to the...
What's your opinion of Rhodes and Big Show?
It's for a belt. That's fine.
Okay.
You kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me?
What?
This is going to be the worst fucking match on the card.
Bullshit!
Bullshit!
Bullshit! The worst match on the card is either the 12...
Shut up! Cody Rhodes is teetering on the edge of Rhodes.
Everyone yelling!
Listen, the worst match on the fucking show is either going to be the 12-man tag match that no one gives a shit, or the Undertaker Triple H match that shouldn't fucking be happening.
Are you going to cry?
No! I'm angry! And running out of breath, because I keep talking without breathing, and that's a bad thing.
My problem
you're putting the head of...
We talked about The Rock, Cena, and yes, the build last night was good.
Did we mention Rock Cena?
Yes, we did.
We did it in the beginning of the show.
Did we talk about that? I don't remember.
We spent like 10 minutes. Okay. The rest of the show, I feel like the build has been shit. Honestly. Like, the only celebrity spot on the whole WrestleMania was built shitty.
Four matches that matter at WrestleMania. Two title matches for the heavyweight and WWE championships, Undertaker, Triple H, and fucking Cena Rock. Yeah. Okay? Everything else is just filler and cooldown shit between the four matches that have the potential to pop the crowd.
The four fucking matches that are gonna finish the pay-per-view! What's there to cool down?
Yeah, see, that's the problem. That's the huge problem. They can't fucking put all these matches and smash them together in a big match sandwich at the end.
No. Like one of the matches. Seriously, what happened last
week? One of those big belt matches is going to open the
entire
wrestling.
It's probably going to be Brian and Sheamus.
It's probably going to be Brian and Sheamus. It's probably going to open the show. But like I was saying last week, the curtain jerker is still an awesome curtain jerker at WrestleMania.
No, yeah, and that's, I'm not saying anything about those matches. Those matches, you know, you can say whatever. The one celebrity spot we have for Mania was booked horribly. The 12-man tag, I don't care what anyone says, it's filler. It's fucking a fill spots.
You know what someone
said? Getting their paycheck.
You know what someone said to me on Twitter today when I was talking about Raw? They said, oh, I don't care about that. I'm just glad that Miz is on it.
What?
No! Miz is in a bullshit spot.
Yes, exactly. You want to know why I know it's filler? Because if it wasn't filler, they would have just had Long and Santino against Laurinaitis and Otunga and found spots for everyone else. But they didn't do that. Why? Because they don't have nothing for them.
Hey. You know what's cool right now? The awesome tag champions that the WWE has? Wait. Guess what? Guess who they're not using at WrestleMania? The awesome fucking tag champions that they have.
You don't know that.
Guess who has pinned victory over those tag team champions? Kofi Kingston and R-Truth.
Exactly! Not to mention the Usos.
Or the Usos, yeah. But then fucking, like, I swear to God, do something with the tag teams. Do something with Zack Ryder besides put him in a bullshit 12-man tag where he's just another guy.
You know how I know this 12-man tag match is bullshit?
How?
Booker T's in it! You know what that says to me? Oh, yeah, we don't give a fuck anymore.
Yeah. The rumor was it was going to be Rey Mysterio to be the final spot, but whoop de fucking do. You know, like, it's filler, and it's clear and obvious that it's filler. I'm glad that Big Show and Cody Rhodes is on, because we finally get the Intercontinental title defended, and the build for that match has been actually pretty good.
That's going to be a barn burner.
I'm not talking about the in-ring stuff, okay? I mean, come on, it's the Big Show.
Talk about the in-ring stuff. What do you like? Okay, fine. All right, we got a card full of shit matches, and a handful of ones are what's going to be good. What's going to steal the show?
Steal the show? Are we talking in-ring? Or are we talking just in general? In general, it's going to be Rock Cena, probably. If we're only looking at the in-ring stuff, it's going to be Punk Jericho.
No, not in ring or out of ring. The whole fucking shebang.
What are you going to remember? What are you going to remember this show
about? When people talk about WrestleMania, it was just
Rock Cena.
Rock Cena, nothing's going to pop out above that.
Probably not. Unless Taker and Triple H do something.
Really?
Really?
Really? Wrestle Fan, I've been really nice to you for the past 2 weeks.
I'm about to jump my foot up your ass. Chachi, that's what I'm saying.
No. Stop. Time out. You went Undertaker Triple H before even breathing to mention CM Punk Jericho.
Punk and Jericho is going to be good in-ring action. We knew Punk and Jericho was going to be a great match before they even booked Punk Jericho. Because we all assumed it was going to be Punk Jericho.
Are you trying to separate in-ring action unnameable quality here?
Well, because you're talking about how Cody Rhodes and Big Show is not going to be a good match.
It's not!
Piece of shit. Everybody knows that.
The build that feud has been awesome.
Has it?
Yes, it has!
WrestleMania, woo!
I know, but no, everything else has been honestly shitty and rushed, you know, in general. The Divas match, the Orton Kane match, which is bullshit. The Punk fucking, the 12-man tag I hate. And I'm saying Taker and Triple H are probably not going to steal the show. Probably, you know.
No,
I'm
that's
just
not what you
that
said.
Match.
You just said that Taker Triple H is probably going to steal the show.
Because Sorg wanted me to say something else.
What?
Wait.
Don't bring me into this.
Oh, no. You're
no,
in
no,
this.
No, no, no.
You are in this.
Don't make me bring the rain down on you.
No Mayhemmy for you.
I said Rock Cena, and you said, well, what about Taker Triple H?
Did I say that?
No.
Yes.
No one said that. No one. Said everyone said that is the match.
CM Punk and Jericho.
CM Punk Jericho.
It's going to be a great
Wait. Guys. You know what I want to know?
Dance off right now.
I want to know what Wheelz thinks.
Oh, sure.
You missed
Bring
my dance
me
off.
Into this. You know what I think?
What?
I think I'm going to be sitting at a college full of Cena haters, cause and a few Cena lovers, and that's what I got to listen to all night, while I enjoy Punk and Jericho, cause I don't care about anybody else in this WrestleMania.
I'm not saying Punk and Jericho is not going to be bad. I'm saying it's not going to steal the show. For us, maybe. For us, it may steal the show.
What?
What the fuck are you talking about?
For internet fans and for, you know, the ones that are clamoring for this match, it's going to steal the show. For the WWE fans, it's going to be there, but they're looking at Rock Cena.
Most of the WWE fans now are internet fans, or on the internet.
Not really.
What?
What?
Hmm?
No, whoa. I think there's a difference. Now, you're classifying the internet fan as a smart mark, work rate, da-da-da-da-da.
I'm not saying, that's the ones that don't give a...
You're talking about those guys. Yeah, no, the fans are on the internet. The fans are not internet fans by your definition.
I'm talking about the fans for the past 5 weeks who have been like, I don't give a fuck about these Rock Cena things.
Okay.
A lot of the WWE fans felt the Rock Cena stuff's been great.
Mm-hmm.
And that's fine. We don't feel it's great because we were bored out of our minds by it. But or we didn't like how The Rock was doing promos or whatever.
Wait, hold on. You make my head hurt. What were we bored from?
The Rock. Because he was doing the same old shit that he did, you know, 10 years ago.
No, we never said it wasn't entertaining. We said it just doesn't work.
Well, you said it wasn't entertaining.
No.
I didn't find it entertaining.
No, Rizz is the one who kept falling asleep when The Rock was talking. I've been Undertaker.
I got over that.
I've been Undertaker.
And I have too, after last week. We're getting off the point.
You're getting off the point!
Hey, you know what you can vote for now?
What?
Well, not now.
Fuck this, I quit!
We're having the Mayhem.
Chachi really leaving.
And he just walked off. Are you happy,
WrestleMania weekend's supposed to be happy, guys.
He just flipped me off and walked out the door. Both fingers.
I don't know what's going on.
What did you do? Wrestle fan! Fuck! Mayhemmies, go! Fuck!
What the fuck? Wow, okay. Mayhemmies this year. So we got a couple...
Wow. Pull it together!
Best Contributor of the Year is the first award we're going to announce. That's for the fans of the Wrestling Mayhem Show that send in the great email, send in the voicemail, send in all of their content into this fine show. The nominees for that award will be Big Freaky, Shane Amazing, a.k.a. The Wolf, Sonic Screwjob, Matt Carlins, and Pierre Kelly.
And Wolf doesn't win this.
Taint the poor or anything.
Not to taint it. No.
If he doesn't win, we're probably going to get shot.
Yeah. Also,
that's good point. So let's taint the pool.
Right, yeah.
All right, next up.
Also, Well, first let me mention that the poll will be on WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You can go vote there to vote for your Mayhemmy.
Got a poll on Wrestling Mayhem Show.
last year, how we did it for most memorable moment, you'll be able to write in your vote because there was a lot of memorable stuff that went on, obviously, this year. So write in your vote. Be as specific as you can. I'm sorry?
Yeah, I agree.
What?
I think we just had that moment.
I think we just did. Well, let me put this into perspective. This is only for the year 2011.
Yes.
So anything from the 2011 year is included in this poll. Don't do anything past 2012.
And I know everybody wants to put it, but I'm pretty sure I didn't get yelled at by a puppet. By a puppet midget this year.
Okay.
Bobby already put out a vote for In the Arms of the Angels.
Yeah.
That would be mine.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you quit. You want your volume back there, sir?
Yes, I do. Fuck you.
Yay, he's back.
For the record, I wasn't flipping you off. I was flipping them off.
Wait a minute. I didn't do a damn thing.
Shut up.
Sorry, sir.
Wow.
Wrestle fan, wow. Continue.
The next category we have is from Best Interview. We had a lot of great interviews this year.
Mm-hmm.
I'll just list them off here. Dave Lagana from IWantWrestling.com.
Now with Impact Wrestling.
Jake Garrett of Black Diamond Wrestling. Johnny Gargano, DJUSA champion. Jimmy DeMarco, obviously, is a sheer favorite. Chad Schaeffler, who I believe was from our comic book series that we did.
Mm-hmm.
John Towers and David Fairhead as well.
Two appearances from the zombie wrestling.
Mike Kingston from Headlocked.
Mm-hmm.
Alan Evans, who I believe was also in the series.
Was it Rival Angels, I think he was?
Rival Angels, yeah. Joe Dombrowski, obviously from IWC, PWO fame. Andrew Lazarchik, who was the
Wildcats.
Wildcat belts, that's right. Making great, including the maker of the TNA World Heavyweight Championship. Amok,
and the U.S. Championship, and Nathan's hot dog belt.
That's true. Amok, who we had on the show to talk wrestling and his latest album. Brian G. Brown from Wrestling Mayhem Show 286. Kes Edison from AON Wrestling.
Rest in peace, AON, not that guy.
Rest in peace, AON.
I was going to say, Jesus Christ, did that guy die?
No, only his company, apparently.
WrestleMania Show 290 and 300, Dan Hinkles from the Wrestling Manager app. Matt Brutal Cow, I believe is how you pronounce it. He from WMS 292. Brandon Oliver from River City Wrestling from WMS 293, and
that was
Ray
this
Rowe.
Year.
I'm sorry.
That was this year.
No, that was 2011.
The guy from the River City Wrestling that we had on like 3 weeks ago.
Oh yeah, you're thinking.
No,
of
that's
ACW.
Anarchy Championship.
You're thinking
Wrestling.
Cast from ACW.
Okay.
Okay. And WMS 294, which featured Ray Rowe from IWC and River City Wrestling.
Hey, you know what? Fuck all of them. I win.
You win for interview of the year?
Yep. Hey, every show they ask me how I'm doing. Boom, interview, I win. Fuck you.
Next one, Russell.
Next category.
So apparently don't vote for that category. Chachi, how you doing? That one's already been filled.
See?
So there's the interview.
Rizz just interviewed me for 2012. I'm going to win that shit too. What?
Chachi's angry.
You're going to be
the next on. Category we have is for Best Supporting Host.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Chachi, you can't really win this one.
Why not?
What?
Why am I not eligible for this award?
Chachi, with his 0.4, he offers a lot of moral support, WrestleFan.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
No, yeah, seriously.
I don't think you're a supporting host. I think, is this the one that we determined that the
supporting host.
Like Chachi,
one,
LB, and
the
I.
These ones that aren't on every week, yeah. You know. Sort of the revolving door.
Oh, what? You know what? I missed 2 weeks last year because I was on surgery, motherfucker.
Oh, I missed a couple weeks too, Chachi. Does that mean I'm best supporting host?
You could be. I didn't make up the rules.
I did, so why the fuck
Who are we voting for?
Yeah. The best supporting host is AJ, Bobby FJ Town, Wheelz, and Rizz.
Hey, you know what? Yes. Fuck you all. I win.
A vote for Chachi is a vote for Rizz.
He's supporting himself.
No.
any vote for Chachi will be transferred into a vote for Rizz.
That's not true. If anyone's going to get my votes, it's going to be AJ. Sorry, Rizz.
Aww.
Maybe next year.
Well, then, and then the final category we have is for Best Host of the Year, which is the big one. It's the one everyone's competing for. Best Host for 2011. The nominees are Sorgatron, we see right there. The DJ Lunchbox.
Yay!
Hey, what's up, hot dog?
Chachi.
Woohoo! Woohoo! Yeah, yeah.
Go fuck yourself.
Wrestle fan, this
boo.
Guy.
Boo!
Former
How'd you best win last year?
And Mad Mike, who we don't have on video.
No, we don't have anything for him. No.
So there we go. Those are your Mayhemmies for this 2011 year. They will be on WrestlingMayhemShow.com, so you can vote there.
Excellent. Oh,
yeah. I'm going
to... For me is a vote to save your feet.
Hey, is a write-in... are there write-in?
There's a write-in for most memorable moments.
Oh.
You obviously missed that part when I said that.
Yeah, I tend to not listen to you, fuckface.
Oh. Yeah, go check it out. And then Mayhem uses the top night where we dress up in the gala. Maybe we'll have a red carpet this year.
I'm not dressing up.
We'll have a red carpet.
I'm not dressing up.
Why would you have a red carpet? We barely see your floor.
I'm not dressing up. Hey.
I get it. You're not dressing up. Yeah. We'll do something. We'll have an audience, and they'll applaud, and they'll be here.
Wait a minute. If we're going to have red carpet, I'll find a redhead, and we'll be fine.
Oh, all right. Let's see. All right. Is there anything else WrestleMania? I think we covered the rest of the matches in that.
I don't think we want to mention anything else.
Okay, we're done with WrestleMania. Is there
WrestleMania?
Chachi scared us all away from WrestleMania.
Yes. This was retweeted or something by.
Wait, hold on. Before we move on, I would like to let you guys know that I will be bringing a shit ton of chicken McNuggets to the WrestleMania party.
Yes.
And the funny thing is, I told Sorg in advance that I was bringing like 800 McNuggets, and I was joking. But I was watching TV yesterday, and the 20 pieces are on sale.
So you're not kidding now.
Yeah, so I'm bringing a shit ton of McNuggets.
Yes, he is. Yeah, we're doing a WrestleMania party. Now, you may wonder, I don't have cable. How are we doing that? Well, WWE, you may not know this, but they do online pay-per-views.
No way!
Yeah, right?
So I don't have to steal it every month.
I don't have to steal it every month. You can drop your $55 for an internet stream. Now, I'm wondering how this is going to go.
Sorky's not a little bitter about that price.
Well, I don't have to because I'm not really buying it, apparently.
It's WrestleMania. It's different.
No, AJ said, hey, I'll foot the bill if you bring it up and invite everybody. I'm like, all right, man. All right. I think it's pretty much part of the culture. If anybody online knows how to click on something, you can find a pay-per-view pretty easily out there. And a lot of people cannot drop.
What's clicking?
Yes, okay, IT boy. And dropping $45 a month on a pay-per-view, sometimes twice, is hard. But we're going to explore this for WrestleMania. We're gonna look at this and see if this is a viable option. Oh. We're hooking a laptop up to the TV, and we're going to do this.
And Bobby, you're going to be there, right?
Oh, he's not in here. He's in the chat room.
I know. I'm just warning
you. But... We're going to see how it is, and is it worth it? Did we have a good experience? Are there any problems? We're going to find out, and we're going to report back to that. And I don't know, maybe we will do these pay-per-views this way if we get enough people together. I don't know, but because do you know anybody that's done an online pay-per-view like this? Like, I don't. And
I don't remember any.
You barely hear them mentioning it. I mean, you really, it used to be, they redesigned it, of course. Like, they got a pretty nice setup now, but it used to be really hard to find this page on their website. And why aren't they pushing this? Because they're getting $55 where it's not split with the cable or the pay-per-view company. So, and you can still buy like old pay-per-views on here for like $20 a piece, and they're still viewable, because I think they're, I think you can watch them anytime. I think like after I buy WrestleMania on here, I'm pretty sure I can rewatch it. So I don't know.
And hopefully, but, I mean, you figure with something that newly redesigned, maybe the flow will be better than previous.
Because I mean,
like, tries.
Have you tried any of them?
No, I know I haven't.
So exactly, and I was really worried about it, considering how the rest of the video used to play on WWE.com. Like, I'm like, really, am I going to pay $40 for like a Windows Media Player's feed? That's kind of cruddy, right? You know, I mean, it's got to be something of quality. And we're going to hook it up to my MacBook here. The picture quality is really good when I hook up to my TV. So, you know, we'll get to figure it out here. And we'll do this, and it'll be a lot of fun. And everybody's coming out. And look, keep an eye on Twitter and everything.
I'm dressing up.
You're dressing up?
Yep.
Wait, what are you dressing up as?
I was just going to wear nice clothes.
But you won't wear it for the Mayhemmies?
Yeah.
Okay. Or you could dress up as your favorite superstar, like Brodus Clay. No? Okay. That reminds me, somebody, I think it was AJ.
Call my mom. Somebody call my mama.
If you haven't played Draw Something, you probably should. Yeah, it was AJ, and I'll hold that up here. He drew me, let's see if this works here. Oh, you can't really see it, but that's Brodus Clay. That he drew for me, and he took his time and drew it.
And let me guess, the draw something was a wrestler.
No, it was Clay.
Oh.
Nice.
He took like 5 minutes to draw Brodus Clay in interesting fashion. I'll post it on Twitter or something. And wrote Brodus and then an underline.
Hmm.
Yeah. But other than that, anything else you guys want to hit on before we head out of here for tonight for this WrestleMania edition?
There was some goings on in with WWE teaching their wrestlers about Twitter.
There was a mandatory meeting, as we mentioned earlier. Mm-hmm. presumably from the tweets, the condescending tweets I've seen, to teach them what a hashtag was for WrestleMania.
I think they all know what a hashtag is.
Oh well, Taz doesn't know what a hashtag is, so apparently somebody in the meeting.
Taz doesn't know much about anything anymore.
No,
I don't think Taz knows what wrestling is anymore.
Well, by the way,
he doesn't watch this show or hear about that. I don't want to die.
But no, hey, Matt Carlin's tweeted us earlier on the Mayhem Show account here. Here's them setting up for the WrestleMania 28 stage. This is back on the 22nd, last Thursday, actually.
Wow.
So that thing's already half set up. I'm sure if you do a flyover, you can get a pretty good idea down there in Miami. So looking forward to that. I'm excited for this. I love these outdoor shows like this. I can't wait to see what they do with the stage again this year. So
I just hope it doesn't rain.
Yeah, I guess. Is that a problem? Are we expecting rain in Miami?
I don't know. Maybe we ought to all check the...
Should we check the weather report? I don't know.
Check the Wrestling Mayhem Show weather report.
I'm a little concerned about WrestleMania this time of year in New Jersey.
That's gonna
next
be
year. So, but hey, I'm gonna get tickets for that. That's it. It's our first chance in the area. You know what I mean?
That's an odd question I just thought about. I mean, what would happen if it rained right now?
I think they have that cover day.
There's a cover over the ring. The ring will be protected in the first several rows there. But everybody else, they start selling ponchos.
Wrestling Mayhem Show. It's like the chairs that they sell, but it's on a poncho.
Now, what happens when it starts lightning?
Well,
you're gonna have someone on the cell.
It makes
when
the Undertaker's entrance
lightning.
Look cooler.
So according to the Weather Channel, Sunday, April 1st, we'll have isolated thunderstorms. High of 84, low of 69. So
10% chance of rain, says Matt Carlin's in the chat. So.
Really? Mine says 30% chance of rain.
Yeah. All right, guys. It's time for that. What did you guys learn from wrestling this week, or the build of the Mania, or anything like that? Let's go around the horn here. DJ LB.
Yes, sir. DJ Saucebox.
What did the Saucebox learn this week?
Reporting for duty. I learned that I'm not sure, but I really feel like WWE wants me to watch this pay-per-view.
You think?
I'm not, I don't, maybe, I don't know. They really want me to watch that one match with that James Cena. Is that wasn't it? James Cena. James Cena.
You're thinking
and,
of Dream that
black dude. They're really into me seeing this, so I might just have to see it.
Excellent. What about you, Wrestle Fan?
I didn't learn anything from WrestleMania. I just know WrestleMania is going to be really good. I learned something from rewatching Monday Night Raw this week. We know that we have problems with the Divas division, and we have problems with Kelly, you know, being a wrestler. Not only does one, she run the ropes like a limp noodle. Not only two, her head scissors thing, like the whole time she does the head scissors, she covers up her boobs like her tits are going to pop out. So I don't know if there's something there. But I also noticed that anytime she punches somebody, she goes pow. Like, she literally says pow every time she punches someone.
So she's a Batman fan.
She's a really big fan of Batman. Or she really wants to make those punches seem real, I guess.
Oh, man. Rizz, what'd you learn from wrestling this week?
What the hell was that?
Just go, man. Just leave it behind.
I learned that the WWE can actually still promote a year-long feud and have it end at WrestleMania.
Like it's the 70s.
Like it's doing, yeah. Like, we had this theory that, oh, The Rock's going to back out or Cena's going to get injured or something like that. But it didn't happen. We're having this match, if we like it or not. And you're going to sit there and like it.
Nice. Wheelz.
Sit there, you're going to shut the fuck up and you're going to like it.
Wheelz, what'd you learn this week?
What did I learn from wrestling and from WrestleMania? I'm actually looking forward to a WWE pay-per-view for once. And it's been a long time. And I'm going to go watch it with a bunch of friends up at a college. And I also learned, don't piss off Chachi.
Yeah, that's correct. Chachi? What did you learn, sir?
Nothing. Go fuck yourself.
Wow. Oh, okay.
Wow.
I didn't learn shit from wrestling this weekend.
I think Chachi needs a hug.
Need a hug, sir?
No.
Need a hug.
Chachi needs a Valium.
Bobby learned that Jericho and Punk is going to steal a show, and it's okay to cry if you slam nearly 8-foot-tall human being.
Sorg?
Mm-hmm.
What did you learn?
I learned from Matt Carlin's in the chat room that weather forecasting is a fraud. And from Bobby that weather.com, the pollen is just going to be insane down there.
Fucking pollen.
Yeah. Actually, the chat cut off the joke. Sorry, Bobby. Hey, I guess that's why it didn't make sense. Jeez, what did I learn from wrestling this week? I have nothing.
Phil.
It's been uneducational. Yeah, I learned, man, ladder matches are hard. Wow. I guess
you like ladder matches and big black men.
Well, I go, oh, you know what? Hey, did I talk about the promo thing? I think I was on Google Plus or something. I did last week. I learned that I was watching NXT, which you should watch. It involves I finally got Dabrowski finally watched at least an episode of it. So I'm hoping he keeps going with that. They play the promo for the Triple H Undertaker stuff. And that's when I realized that what we've been seeing this whole time, what we've been seeing this whole time is the filming of a movie, which are these promos that we see leading up to WrestleMania, and only then do things make sense with the way they fit together when they've been edited properly and to sweet Metallica music,
it's like Memento.
Yeah, kind of like that. Much like you know, Chachi was talking about with the you know, the big documentary. His entire year has been filming all the parts to the movie that was the documentary that goes right before the big grand finale of the match that you're going to see this Sunday at WrestleMania. It was same with all this stuff. It was boring while we were there, but now you look back and look at this promo, and I was like, man, that was some hot shit right there. Until they change the Metallica song on the DVD because they don't have the rights. but there you go. So we're all part of the movie filming, and now we get to see the benefits of the opening night on Sunday, April 1st. So, with that...
Whoa, that was deep.
Yeah.
Wow.
With that...
By Sorgatron.
Hey guys, Wrestling Mayhem Show, of course, go to WrestlingMayhemShow.com where all those Mayhemmies will be, as well as any other articles we'll be coming up here.
Vote for Chachi.
Vote for Chachi.
Vote Rizz.
Wait. Don't I get a vote? I get a vote?
No.
All right.
A vote for Chachi is a vote for freedom.
At Mayhem Show, tag us, hashtag WMS 314 for this episode if you want to have any comments about it or questions.
I may have attack ads.
Send email at
good time
at WrestlingMayhemShow.com or 412-206-WMS0. If you want to be part of this live, sorry about the part, join us in the chat room at live.sorgatronmedia.com around 8:30 p.m. Eastern Time. Every Tuesday night, just like Matt Carlin, just like Jehovah 301, joining us tonight, Bobby F. J-Town, and the rest out there, Juggalo, John, all the rest of you, man, Mike. And that's it. It's WrestleMania weekend, guys! Have Peace. Fun! Tweet us, see us on Twitter, at Sorgatron, and everybody else, DJ Lunchbox, at the Wrestle Fan, at Chachi says, maybe there'll be a live stream, maybe we'll be a hangout. Who knows? We'll see you guys next week. Who Mayhem knows? Out!
Just wait. Just wait.